Light is pretty much the most important thing for any living and non-living thing on Earth. And all light, whether it's artificial or natural, originates from the sun. Not to mention all of the Earth's heat, which comes from the sun. But what if one day, all of a sudden, our sun went out? Maybe it goes out for a few minutes, or an hour, or maybe a day or a month. What about an entire year or hundreds of years? Well, the Earth would be a very different place, and that's what we're going to look at today. This is a hypothetical, but it could happen in real life. In 4.5 billion years, the sun will actually die. But scientists say a space anomaly could end the sun's life at any point. So the sun goes out. 1 second after, life would go on like normal. Light takes 8 minutes to travel from the sun to planet Earth. This means the last photons and particles in the solar wind are heading to Earth. The average temperature on Earth right now would be the same. But after 8 minutes, the sun would no longer be visible to Earth. Planes and boats experiencing clear visibility would all of a sudden be in the dark. There would be many car pileups. Any rooms, buildings, and locations with no artificial light would be totally dark. About a minute later, people would come to their senses and realize the sun has gone out. Mass panic would then likely ensue. From now on, it would be permanently nighttime. Also, time zones would cease to exist. It would make no difference if you were in the USA or Australia. Wherever you are at any time, it would be night. All of these stars would be clearly visible with the black backdrop of the sky. This is because there would be no light pollution coming from the sun. We would also not be able to see the moon and get any light from that. That's because there's no longer any sunlight for the moon to reflect. There would be mass changes in the Earth's magnetic field. This means we'd see some pretty amazing stars, and we'd likely see northern lights in many parts of the world. After 8.5 minutes, the gravitational pull of Earth would stop. Earth would stop rotating around our sun, and instead, it would begin to travel through space in a straight line. Other distant planets would also begin to disappear. That's because they have no light to reflect. After 9 minutes, stars would be our only source of light. The remaining stars would provide a very small amount of light to Earth, so we'd have to rely on a lot of artificial light in order to see. After 9 minutes, one of the worst things about having no sun would occur. That is, photosynthesis totally stopping. This means plants and cyanobacteria no longer produce any oxygen. This will make life very hard for every living being, and it could pretty much be the end of life on Earth as we know it. The good news is, if photosynthesis stopped now, we would have some oxygen left. Right now, we'd have enough oxygen to breathe for 370 years. But after that, any new life on Earth would not have enough oxygen. Solar panels would become obsolete after 9 minutes. The sun is our best source of renewable energy because it's totally natural and massive. This would cause massive power outages all over the entire planet. After all, a fair amount of our energy now comes from renewable sources. And all of these would be affected by the sun going out. After 30 minutes, Mars would disappear. This is because Mars is further away than the moon. The remaining light from Mars would take longer to arrive, but after 30 minutes, we wouldn't be able to see it at all. After 1.5 hours, Jupiter would also disappear. This is because of a delay in light refraction. After 2.5 hours, Saturn would disappear too. Saturn is the most distant planet that can be seen with the human eye. After a couple of hours, temperatures everywhere would drop by several degrees, and the surface of Earth would begin to cool very slowly. But the sun's inner core would still be very hot. After 12 hours, Pluto would disappear. Pluto is 8.2 billion kilometers away from Earth. This means the light would take a long time to get to Earth. But after 12 hours, we'd never be able to see Pluto again. By now, the world would be in a state of panic and chaos. There would likely be riots and civil unrest in every country on Earth. The very few people cut off from civilization like tribes wouldn't know what was going on. Because many communication systems would be down, state authorities would have a hard time controlling what's going on. Many humans would still be in a state of shock trying to figure out what was going on. Some spiritual people may believe that the apocalypse or end of the world is here. After 24 hours, the temperature on Earth would severely drop. The greenhouse effect means some heat would remain in the atmosphere, but the world would still be much colder than before. After 32 hours, people will have realized that life will never go back to being the same again. Looting and mayhem would erupt in countries all over the world. Scientifically, people feel safer committing crimes in the dark, and people would be scared, thinking that this is the end of the world. This means they'd likely try and loot food and ammo to survive. After a couple of days, the Earth's temperature would be 5 to 7 degrees Celsius, or 41 to 45 degrees Fahrenheit. This is a decrease of around 20 degrees Celsius, or 68 degrees Fahrenheit. This causes some plants and microorganisms to pass away, but any ocean creatures don't feel much change for now. After 1 week, the global temperature would drop to 0 degrees Celsius. That's around 32 degrees Fahrenheit. It's still dark, and by now most plants will have passed away. This is because of the cold temperature and lack of light. Herbivorous animals which need heat also begin to pass away. Phytoplanktons in the oceans will also begin to die too. The surface of the ocean begins to turn to ice, and any creatures living in shallow waters will have been frozen solid. After 3 weeks, humanity will have had to move underground. Mole people will become a reality. This is to preserve the temperature. Seeing as the only thing keeping us warm is Earth's core, people move closer to it. And this goes for animals as well, who can burrow down underground. Certain governments and powerful people will be hiding out in shelters. After 4 weeks, humans will begin to get very depressed. Not only has their life been ruined by the lack of sun, but vitamin D from the sun is also a mood enhancer. After 1 year without sun, the temperature on Earth will continue to drop. After the first year, the only way to survive would be living underground. After 1 year and 2 months, the oceans would have frozen. And after 1 year and 6 months, the Earth's temperature would be minus 73 degrees Celsius. That's nearly minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And after 5 years, human life would cease to exist. Temperatures would reach a point where we could not dig deep enough. Eventually, only the most tough humans who were left on Earth would have been frozen solid. After 10 years, the Earth would become wet with dew. The air would become so cold, it would basically turn into water. After 20 years with no sun, all trees would die. The reason they can last so long is because of their sugar storage and slow metabolism. After 1,000 years with no sun, the temperature would be minus 240 Celsius, or minus 400 degrees Fahrenheit. After 1,500 years, the atmosphere would have frozen. Nitrogen molecules have a freezing point of minus 210 degrees Celsius. This would cover the Earth in snow. With no atmosphere, this would cause meteors to rain down on Earth. These would form gigantic craters in the ground. After 43,000 years, the Earth would reach Alpha Centauri. Remember, the Earth is no longer rotating around the Sun, but going in a straight line. After 1 billion years, Earth would have traveled 100,000 light years. After 3 billion years, the Earth would pretty much just be water. But amazingly, some parts of the ocean would still have heat. This would only be the deepest parts, such as the Mariana Trench. After 50 billion years, some organisms would still be alive. That's because some can survive at extreme temperatures with no photosynthesis. After 55 billion years, Earth would collide with another planet during its journey through space. And after 60 billion years, we'd be pulled into a black hole. After 70 billion years, ice would melt and microbes would have a chance to evolve into life. And after 100 billion years, life would restart. The chance of these microbes evolving into humans are close to zero. So they'd kind of be like an alien life form we've never seen before. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Comment below which is the scariest thing about the sun going out. If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. But as always, thanks for watching. There are some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.